the last thing I want to mention is some common issues, that is, all these thin film technologies, they have a similar way of making the module, and they have a similar way of making the contacts as well. So the module, again, from if you look from outside, it looks like a big panel of glass. But of course, that big panel of glass is not exactly one solar cell. That would be really bad, because it would have such a big electrode area, and you will lose a lot of your generated electron and holes before you actually collect them. So what is done is that big panel of glass is broken into these individual cells, which are connected in series. So from the outside, it looks like this big shiny piece of glass. But what you do is you start with that big piece of glass, but then when you deposit your first TCO material, or your first electrode, which is a conductive oxide, it could be either zinc oxide or tin oxide. Once you deposit it, you pattern it into by using this laser scribes. And then when you are done depositing your other layer, in this case, this is amorphous silicon cell. So you again, you deposit your amorphous silicon, then deposit your back contact. Then again, you do a laser scribe. So these are, you know, scribes of laser which come and cut your cell. And what it results is, it results in this individual blocks which are now connected in series. So here's another picture showing the same. So even though from the outside it looks like a big piece of glass, it's actually broken into these different small cells, which are then connected in series with each other, so that you from each of these cells you are able to collect your carriers effectively. And this is done by using this laser scribe, which is used to separate these layers into individual cells. So this is how most of these modules. This is the first solar modules. Amorphous silicon modules are even bigger because you have the capability of making bigger amorphous silicon from your display technology, because that's the same material which was used for the display black backplane. So it's the same tools that are used for making these solar cells. So next time you take a you see one of these things on the roadside, on a roof, you know, pay closer attention, and 90% of the time you can pretty much pinpoint the manufacturer just by looking at it. In parallel, you get higher, so first thing is you want to get like a voltage you can easily convert to AC, right? So typically wire like 36 of them, each has a VOC of between 0.6, 0.7, so that gives you like 18, 20 volts in series. And then these panels are then connected in parallel. If you connect all of them in parallel, you'll still get that same voltage, of VOC of your each cell. So they're combined in using a combination of series and parallel. So on a module level, they are connected in series, and then these individual panels are then connected in parallel. And you want to get to an optimum point. So, like for example, they are connected in series, and there's some dust, or there's some shading, right? Or there's some leaf which falls on one, so it will damage one panel. So you want to have a bypass diode, and that diode which prevents that is on a panel level. So on a panel level, they are connected in series, and then they are connected in parallel. So the last thing I want to cover is the contacts, and these are called TCOs. That stands for a three-letter acronym standing for transparent conducting oxides. So the way you make these transparent electrodes is using these metal oxides, either zinc oxide or tin oxide or indium tin oxide. And the requirement you have on these is that you want these to be very low in sheet resistance so that you know you don't have too much loss or resistive loss and you can collect all your carriers. But at the same time, you want them to be transparent throughout the solar spectrum. And then you want them to be high conductive. And then you want them, also people want to use them as a light trapping material. So they want to introduce morphology on this TCO material such that it acts as a light trapping material as well. And these are all conflicting requirements because if something is transparent, that typically means you know it doesn't have free carriers. So it means that it should not have good conductivity. But so you want it to be transparent over the spectrum, but still be good conductivity. So these are all conflicting requirements. And typically, when your resistivity increases, your decreases, your transmittivity also decreases. And the other thing people do with this TCO is that they texture it. And this is done very easily by dipping it in a, you know, etch and it forms this microstructures. And these microstructures help in increasing this efficiency.